Buckeye Nation, they're just informing 108,000 people showing up after a tough loss a week ago, so, you know, I can't speak for everybody, but what drives me, drives a lot of our players and our coaching staff, is not letting them let Buckeye Nation down, so. From our heart, thank you for your support again, and, you know, it was a beautiful day, and horseshoe against a good football team. A team that, you know, just had nice talk with our players. You know, my father was in the Army, my sister's in the Air Force. Spent many times against Air Force Academy, played Navy several times. Never been to Annapolis yet, I will. And then I took my son to West Point. We stayed in General Blake's house. They were great, you know, gracious, took us to the firing range and just saw some of the coolest things I've ever seen. And that's been a bucket list of mine to go do that. It's easy to, you know, to put your head on the pillow by knowing that men and women that represent our country, it's awesome. And so that was a great experience to play them. It was a pain in the rear end. They had an 18-play, 99-yard drive, and they just wore you out. It was 14-7. Our defense coach, I don't know, defensive staff, did a great job. And obviously the players, Tuck Warren came in and did a heck of a job. And then finally, just a thought on JT is, I've known about the Big Ten Conference for probably 40-some years, and of all the great players that ever played here, to say you're the number one touchdown maker in the history of the Big Ten Conference, that's awesome. That's something that's going to be hard to break because he's got a lot of games left. So much credit to him, and appreciate him. So I'll answer any questions for you.
Front row right, Bill.
Can you describe how difficult this past week was for you, and how much of a necessity having a game like this was psychologically?
Yeah, losing is awful, and it was the typical. It's not the first time. I hope it's the last time. You know, sometimes those things happen. You work really hard not to allow it to happen, and you go through the discomfort of being crushed. To extremely angry and self-reflection, what could you have done better? And then you have to somehow pull yourself off the canvas and get going. And how do you do that? You do that with your faith, your family, your friends, and your teammates. And that's why a lot of us have very narrow circles. Just what I mentioned, the most important are players. So they did a good job. A guy like Billy Price is a strong guy. He picks his way off the canvas and let's go.
Second row wide left, Tony.
Erwin, Tuck Marlin came in. Was that a performance issue on Chris Worley's part?
No, he has a little spring foot, and Tuck played fantastic.
Do you think that's a position that becomes a competition
sure.
More so now?
Well, I mean, it's, you know, Worley's a leader, but anybody that plays well gets an opportunity.
Front row right, Austin.
Erwin, this wasn't the first time this week that JT's had some adversity or had people question him. He's always seemed to bounce back traditionally throughout his career. What is it about him that allows him to make those plays, make those games come back? And did you have any conversations, notice anything different with him throughout this week?
The heart of a lion, you know, it's a heart this big. And the toughness is one of the toughest players I've ever been around. So it's pretty good characteristics to have a guy touching the ball every single
day. Back row left, Ari.
JT was one touchdown away from that record. How aware are you during games about how close a player is to breaking a record like that? And do you think about that? Do you keep him in longer? And, you know, just how?
No, I wasn't aware of that one until I saw it pop up on the screen. Sometimes we all not very often, though. Like someone said, I remember Zeke or something, he needs 5 yards. And then you start going through your mind, you know, there's your opponent, you know, you got hurt. So that did happen. It's happened.
And front row right, Tim?
Yeah, but J.K. Dobbins, obviously, his first 2 carries in the second half, 22 and 52 yards, get you guys some breathing room there. Just, what did you see there? What have you seen of him just taking the bid here his first 3 games as a freshman?
Well, we saw it against Indiana. You know, unfortunately, we didn't get him in space. He's a perfect tailback. You know, he's a space player that we need. And Shane Paris had the one call back because that was a lightning bolt, too. So we got the breakaways developed. You know, we tried to shoot it down the field a couple times. They're playing just such soft coverage; it was hard to get behind them. But J.K. and Paris, they're two of our best playmakers right now.
Front row right, Jeff.
And were y'all determined to hammer inside as much as anything else today? Y'all did the wide
No, you do. You know, we had a lot of outside plays, yeah, too. Yeah. Those plays that hit were outside plays. And then like Kevin Wilson and Ryan did a nice job mixing matching. It's all how you play, how they're playing. And I thought the RPOs were very good. That's the run pass options were a lot of us time to see JT pull the ball and kick it out there and get really push it. We've got to keep growing.
Front row left.
Coach Meyer, in the first quarter, JT still tended to overthrow the ball to players like Mac and Lauren. Do you think him tying the record for two threes made up for that? Compensated for overthrowing the ball.
Yeah, he misfires. He's 25 to 33. Yeah, I was hoping to do 33 for 33 passing, but sometimes you misfire a little bit. But I saw what you saw. He had a couple misfires.
Front row right over here, Clay.
How helpful to get Haskins in the game, and now you kind of start to bring him along a little bit?
I hope so. I thought he performed well when he was in there. It was 4-for-4, and I wanted to throw more, but you just didn't want to put him in. Silly. I thought he did very well again. That's his first chance.
Special arm.
Quick release.
And final two questions, far left, Doug.
Urban, I know obviously you guys did a good job on some of those perimeter throws and spacing that a little bit, but sometimes it looks like if you just hand it to the tailback every play, you guys could have put up 60 if you wanted to. Do you have
it's
a
just that easy, right?
Yeah, but it's more than that.
First of all, it's much more than that.
No, I know. But you did give it to JK the first two times in the second half, and you went 2 yards, 74-yard drive. But
just give it to him.
Yeah. Do you know, and I asked you this during the week, but do you still have, you need to throw, right? I mean, even if you think you could run every time, and I know it's not that
you
easy, but you have to do, you have to be balanced, you have
yeah,
to
the
do
reason it runs, just to help you a little bit with it, and I'm an expert, just to clarify a few things, what makes the inside run game open up is when you start hitting all the screens and a lot of the horizontal pass plays too, or eventually it just getting tighter and tighter. So you have to be very balanced. I think we were very balanced today. Remember that 300.
But is that
316 passing and 270 rushing? So that's about where we need to be. But you do have to in the big games. You have to be balanced because they can stop you.
But you're pretty happy with that balance. That's how you would like it to look.
Very game.
And final question over here to the right, Steve.
Coach Shiano was down on the field today. What did you see in terms of doing that? Was that because of what Army does and you expect him to go?
Combination of both. He's an energy guy. He provides a lot of energy. He's coached against this offense for many, many years. I want him to sound like energy and make adjustments. And we'll reevaluate for if he's going to see that.
Did somebody go up in his place?
No, Coach Davis.
Coach, thank you very much.